Toledo RC, and we're going to be doing engine prep and install on this video. I have a few different things out. Of course, I have. Bring the camera up a little bit. Of course, I have the engine, which the Signature Series OBR34CC reed case. Got my modded carburetor 990. Got my velocity stack from DDM. Model number AF317. I have my Bartolone Racing billet ignition coil spacer. Model number EE414. I have my from DDM again, Kraftwerks MSD red cable, model number EE820. Of course, I have the flywheel cover in red to match the engine. Outerwear's free filter. And I have the pull start in red, outerwear's free filter. So we're basically going to turn the engine down. You know what I mean by turn down? I'm going to take this off and take this little cord off. No problem. Put the carb on. Add all the stuff in. So let's get to it. First thing first, let me get the proper machinery out. I need that. I need a 4 mil and a 3 mil. Okay. 3 mil speed bit. 4 mil speed bit. Oh, matter of fact, I got these ball drivers by hand. This is a 4 millimeter. And this is a 3 millimeter. Real soft grip, very nice. I use these probably more than I actually use my MIPs. So you got the ball tips on them and real soft grip. Can't go wrong about these on Amazon. They're by Bond Huss. Comes with a whole set from two to five mil. So we're going to take this apart. Sitting here getting my magnet tray together. So I'm just basically, I usually unloosen everything first before I actually take the drill to it. Also, try to do the same thing when I'm tightening everything up. I take the drill to it, put it on the torque setting that I need, and then hand tighten it from there. And with the MSD cable, I doubt if I need all of that.
quick.
Might as well. I already went this far with it. Okay, so this is the same. I usually buy these, got the metal cog in there. Have they kind of torqued down in there?
Yeah, they torqued those.
Move the top plate to the side. Okay, you know what? Should have ran my kill switch while I was involved with all this. But, do that at a different time. That has a little more torque on it, so we're gonna take with the one I love the best, this wrench. About way too much. Talk about tight. Shit, must have used some Loctite on that. Believe it or not, I do not like using Loctite on this, on that part with a coil, on the coil itself. Let's see. I don't see any Loctite. This was real. This was real tight in there. Okay, first we're going to put the MSD plug wire on there. Figure out where my spacers have went. There we go. Two spacers. All right. First thing first. I'm gonna pull this back out so I can put my MSD plug wire, release the glue off of it. Okay, boom. Got that now. Start unscrewing it. Thank you. Now smooth. Listen, that's the Craftworks complete MSD cable install with the red to match the rest of the beautiful work. So now, you can see how this pulls apart. I have already installed, and this is also from DDM. I keep this in the bag. There's a NOAA flywheel air gap tool. Lets you get it precise. Better than the business card. But this is actually thinner than a business card. Use the Dremel to Dremel that out so that it can fit the cable. Dremel up. I like to keep, try to keep this stuff out my way. I always use cable ties on everything. Everything with a cable. Use a cable tie. Nice and neat. Alright. Pull out the crankcase outerwear. So I don't need scissors, it's already open. Don't need that. I use this. Well, already, matter of fact, I already have it on the engine because this engine already had one on there. You gotta finagle it. Now I do need to come across here with some. So, and this right here actually sticks to a billet case way better than it does a regular case. basically want every contact to be covered. So we're going to do the same thing on this billet part. Get your stick on her. For right now, just make sure the stick's on her. So far, and that's the installation outerwear's crankcase. Now for the pull start. This trim around right up outside of the case. Running trimming. You see what I'm doing? Just running trimming right around outside of the case. Perfect. So I'll make sure it's molded around the case. You say you usually want to let this sit for a day, but when I put it on, I don't pull it off anyway, so. Install the cover. Got the screws. this tight now. Now for the pull starter. Only parts left is the carburetor, the velocity stack, and the outerwear for the pull starter. Three mil out. And I always use just regular pull starts. Especially when it's a lot of compression. I find these work just best for me, regular pull starts. Just a couple of tightens. Even more. Now I always I always cut my tag out. And I cut right here. That way, I don't have to take this off just to put this on. I can quickly take this off and clean it. No, right. That's a signature series, OBR. Maybe we clean it up real quick. I'm gonna spray it down real quick, wipe the table. Get all that modification dust off of it. Now let's see this again. Got the crankcase outerwear installed. Got the MSD cable installed. Inside of here, we got the billet Bartolone ignition spacer. Got the pull start outerwear. This engine is ready. Fully prepped engine. Now we're going to put the carb on it. Hold on to that because I'm going to reuse that. Sent all of this also. You always want this facing down, because that's where the hole is, the track. So, let me get my unbag my velocity stack. Break out that hardware. Washers and lock nuts. Velocity stack has the gasket inside. I like this one because it's flat. Works pretty well. Works better than this one. I also have this one, but I don't like this one. You got to get extended bolts for this one because it don't go all the way in. This one, if you notice, this velocity stacks goes all the way back. This one doesn't. So you got to get longer bolts just to use this one. Don't care for that. And it does not come with the bolts, the hardware, like this one does. This one comes with all this hardware. So it's cost a little more, but it's worth the money. It's only a couple bucks more, but that means the world to some people. Getting all my stuff on here straight. That's why I just put this in here. Actually, almost forgot first. Washer, lock nut. Velocity stack. Washer, lock nut, velocity stack. Got those two in. Go with the gasket. Go with the carb. Then after that, you got your, still got your spaces. Go with a nice heavy duty. That on there. Make sure that's facing down. So you still got your space. Then last one. This is where you gotta have your little steady hand. I got ways around that. That's simple. And now, got that on there. I think they torch this down. This is to get torqued down on this application is 65 ounce inches of torque. But I just make sure, I just torque it down with this. And make sure I don't overdo it. Always just a couple of times. Cause this gives a, like, a lot more thrust than what you know. And that's it. So now I'm not going to put them. Make sure I cover this back up. You put that inside until I get ready to use it. Just to make sure that hole is covered. And that is the Velocity Stack fully installed. And that modded 990 carb. Oh, this is ready. Looks real good. Real good. I'm also going to be changing this out. I got a couple options that I want to go with it. It's a nice clutch though. I got a 9,500 RPM spring. I might be putting this out of there. Yeah, I get to it before I install it. Real sexy. Look at that. It's fucking beautiful. Fucking beautiful. Look at that. Can't stop spinning it around. Now we have the engine so far. I gotta bring out, hook this up to it. All from the TLR kit. Clutch bell housing, pendant clutch bell. TLR, beautiful. Also comes with a 20 tooth pinion. A bit of hard work. In this bag, you have my air filter housing. I may have to break my booklet back out for this. It's been a while since I've seen this stuff. TLR kit bag. Fuel line. I doubt if I'll be using this. It's not as thick as the Tigon. Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna be using this fuel line. We'll find out. So. This got a hook on. Right here.
Okay.
Not a problem. Let's get to this part first. So. Use a 3 mil. I said 2.5. And that's off. First thing first, we're going to come on this side, feed these back in. Spark plug protector. That's fine. And that's a spark plug protector installed. Perfect. Protect the top of the motor. Top of the engine supports. Okay, a lot of people use this on their 5Ts also. Therefore, when the body in the cage flex in, it won't hit the top and break the spark plugs off. So far we got that on. So I can put all my screws up. You got to keep screws. Whenever I take some out, I never throw my screws away. I put them in containers. This is 4 washers. See what size that is. It looked like a 3 or 4. Is that a 4? Yep, it's 4 millimeter. coming out just beautiful. Just beautiful. And what do you know? All of that just made no sense at all. I'm putting over the clutch bell housing and didn't even install the clutch first. Didn't even install the clutch bell itself. So busy looking for the screw threw me off of what I was trying to do. And now back to the installation. Then we forgot the essentials. Must be real tired. Beautiful. I had to get a long one, break out my DDM set. I told you I always torque down with this. Now the engine is ready for drop in. That's fucking beautiful. That is beautiful. It's got a little weight to it too.